me on Facebook, you know I've been posting a lot about this lately. This is a very important issue to me, and it concerns my life. Not only my life, but the lives of so many other people who have horrible health issues, and they need this safe, natural alternative to turn to, rather than use the medications that the doctors like to dish out that have horrible side effects and don't work anyway. Before I really begin, let me say that even though the petition has reached its goal of 100,000 signatures, please continue to keep signing that, because our voices need to make a big impact upon people, and the more people we have behind us, the better. Many of you haven't heard of Kratom, and about 3 years ago I hadn't heard of it either, but I got it to try it because I have severe fibro pain and many other problems. As soon as I started taking the Kratom, the pain went away. It blocks the pain receptors in your brain from telling you that this horrible pain is going on in your body, and so you get like immediate relief from the pain. Not only that, but it doesn't have any side effects. Like all the prescriptions that the doctor likes to give me have horrible side effects that I can't handle, and so I can't use that kind of medicine. It's why I turned to Kratom. I also have a panic disorder and PTSD, and Kratom does help significantly with those issues too. It also helps people with depression, autoimmune disorders, so many other things. I'm just so emotional that it's hard for me to do this video. So I'm probably leaving out a lot of things I want to say. But I need to make the video regardless, because I need people to know how important this is to me. Without this medicine, my life will never be the same if they ban it. And even if you may not need it now, you may need it in the future, and if you don't help stop this ban, it will not be available to you in the future when you do need it. And I'm pretty sure you're going to need it in this world, especially America, because they love to push out antidepressants on us, which do more harm than good, in my opinion. There's just no comparing the two. You have Kratom that helps with no side effects, and doctor meds that don't really help but cause more problems and have horrible side effects. Which would you choose? It's the thing is that Kratom helps people, and that's causing issues with the medical business. It's interfering with their sales. That's the real problem. That's why they want to ban it, so that people have to suffer and go to more doctors more frequently, get on more medications. It's all business. There is nothing dangerous about Kratom. I don't care what you hear on the news. Look up your own facts, do your own research, find out your own information from people who have actually taken it. I can tell you, without it, I don't know what I'm going to do. When I'm having horrible fibro pain episodes, when I wake up in the morning, it's so hard to get out of bed. The pain is so intense. Oftentimes, my joints will lock up and I can't even move them. Like my elbow, my wrist, I won't be able to move them until I get up and take the Kratom medicine. And then it's like I'm back to normal. The DEA wants to ban Kratom. And if they do this, it will be in the same category as heroin. It will be illegal. Not only will you won't be able to buy it anymore, but if you're caught having Kratom, which is a safe, natural, herbal alternative, if you're caught in possession of it after the ban, you will be charged with a felony. And this is a big deal. It's completely unnecessary, and this shouldn't even be happening in the first place. It's why I've been so emotional all week. It's why I haven't been able to make a video until now, because I've been crying every day over this, because I don't know what the heck I'm gonna do if they ban it. There goes my life. I will exist. I will have an existence. that existence will be in severe agonizing pain all the time. And I don't want to go back to living like that. It wasn't living. I couldn't do anything. This kratom saved my life. It made me able to go do things where otherwise I wouldn't have been able to. Kratom helps so many people with so many varying symptoms or ailments or diseases. It's incomprehensible, and there needs to be more research done on this so that we can realize its full potential, which I'm sure is much greater than anybody could perceive. But if they ban it, they will no longer be doing research on it for its benefits. That's why, another reason why this ban cannot take place. Alcohol causes so many problems, health effects, side effects. People die from drinking and driving. Prescription medicines. So many people overdose on them, and they're prescribed to these people legally. And a lot of the time, I'm sure those people didn't mean to overdose. It's just that the pills have so many side effects that things happen like that. Those are the drugs that should be banned, not something that helps people. I can't even drink a cup of coffee because I'm very sensitive to everything I take. But Kratom is something that works so well with my body. It's very compatible. That's why it helps so much, and that's why I need it to stay legal. Not only for me, but for so many other people who are like me and have the same health issues. If this ban does go through, can you imagine the people who have severe pain, the people who wake up every day in severe agony, having nothing to turn to because Western medicine has failed them? What are they gonna do? I think this ban will send so many people to their deaths, so many people to early graves, because they won't be able to exist. I can't talk. I'm so upset. We needed as much support as we can get, and if I post something on Facebook concerning Kratom, if you could just share it to your friends, that would help. Ask them to share it too. We need to get the public more educated on the benefits. There are far more benefits than this with this Kratom than there will ever be side effects. The things that you can do to help. Sign the petition. Even though it's reached its goal, please continue signing it. If you want to write to your senator, that would be great. You can look it up online very easily. And you can even write to the president, which I've done all of those three things. And I've also written to the DEA themselves. This deadline is so close. We have so much limited time, and we need to do so much in that limited time. This is why we need mass support. If you're on my Facebook account, I posted a link recently about strategies for stopping this ban from going through. You could look on there and find the paper. I printed it out. You can also write to the Assistant Secretary of Health, and you can write to the Department of Justice, which I will be doing after I post this video. It's not just me who needs this. So many people depend on it, and if it's not there to turn to, I fear what's going to happen. So I'm going to end this video for now, and if I get any more information about this in ways that you can help, I'll post another video soon. So I'll see you in the next video.